Welcome to Nasdaq Trade Talks. I'm Jill Malandrino, Global Markets Reporter at Nasdaq. Joining me is Kris, Co-Chief Investment Officer of the Ambrus Group, a volatility arbitrage-focused firm, to discuss the vol regime in the tech space. Kris, it's great to meet with you. Welcome to Trade Talks.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
All right, let's take a quick look back here. February and March both gave way to heavy negative sentiment in tech. There were three main themes that the market was fixated on. Let's review.
Yeah, so, you know, I think it's nobody's surprise that the art complex was a big deal. You know, the rebalancing process that was taking place in the arts complex had a lot of retail traders and also regular investors pretty worried. You know, no real fear actually struck in tech, but just the dynamic of their process of selling the liquid names and buying the illiquid names, sort of like martingaling their way down, it had some people concerned. I think the other thing was the rotation theme, right? So one thing that you noticed pretty heavily in a lot of the sell side research that was coming out was a lot of these sell side banks were actually pushing this rotation theme where you had the rotation out of tech into value. And in a way, this almost becomes like a self-fulfilling prophecy, right? The clients look at this research and they're like, oh yeah, okay, this is the trade. So they kind of follow the trade. And then, you know, the move in rates that you've seen in the 10-year was pretty big as well. I think that also put a little bit of fear in some people's hearts, and they were like, oh, okay, maybe this, you know, this rotation is actually happening. The final complex that I thought was a big deal was the fear of capital gains tax, right? It's something that actually right now is still on the table. However, it seems the market has actually shrugged all three of these formats kind of off to the side as, you know, tech continues to rally into this OPEX.
And we'll get into that in one second, but I also want to discuss, you were tweeting in March that the short interest in the Qs got to the highest point it's been since February 2018. What's significant about that?
Yeah, that's a really big deal. You know, so from a Delta One perspective, if you look at what was taking place in the Qs and also, you know, NDX, if you look at NDX when it was around 13,000, that like late February, early March type of frame, there was a bunch of people that were actually piling in short, just outright short. So from a Delta One perspective, you had a lot of people that were just naturally short outright because of, you know, these three moving factors that I listed before. What's interesting is that now from that like 13,000 level, all those people are underwater, you know, because tech has rallied back. From a derivative standpoint, if you look at the puts were almost lean 2-to-1, sorry, actually 3-to-1 going into this OPEX, which is a significant deal as well, because when we actually went back and we recalibrated the vols, we actually noticed that there was a lot of buy side buying, right? So the downside buying to the puts were actually more so buy side driven, which in itself, it leads way to this, this VANA complex where you have a lot of people are reaching for downside puts, dealers are short puts, in order to hedge off their risk when that vol actually compresses, they need to buy back stock, right? So this has reflexive actions on the equity itself. So you have two big factors that are actually moving the equity. It's from a Delta One perspective, people are just outright short. And, you know, now you're having some short covering as tech kind of pulls up, comes back up. And then from a derivative standpoint, you know, going into the OPEX, you have dealers hedging off their risk.
So, Kris, let's recap here. The picture is quite different than what we saw in February, March. VOLQ is getting crushed, right? NASDAQ 100 is trading near all-time highs, give or take, with some of the action we're seeing this Monday afternoon. Futures point to a muted vol regime in the coming months. Do you see any opportunities here then with this backdrop?
Yeah, you know, so I think there's a lot of opportunity in the equity space when you're thinking about equity vol. To us specifically, you know, we focus on short dated tenor as gamma hogs, you know, so equity vol land has presented a lot of good opportunity with the way how vol is compressed. However, you know, for the tech space specifically, tech carries a very heavy beta during a sell-off, right? So there's very heavy vol that takes place during a sell-off. And this is no surprise to anybody, you know, this is a factor that everybody generally knows. So I think that there's a lot of ways to actually harvest the VRP in the tech space when you get that big vol expansion on these small pullbacks that we see in the market, right? So the market does have its little pullback. An area that you could actually look to harvest the VRP would and should be tech. Because, you know, everybody is looking to actually pile on and buy tech volatility, which in itself just naturally misprices it. So instead of jumping on the bandwagon and buying something for, you know, very rich vol, we're actually looking at the other way of doing this in a more risk-defined capped vega type of structure, right? So not selling volatility uncapped, but looking at a way to harvest the VRP in a more defined risk type of structure.
All right, Kris, appreciate the insight. Thanks for joining us on Trade Talks, and thanks for joining me. I'm Jill Malandrino, Global Markets Reporter at Nasdaq.
Thank you for having me.